knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
We have been examining drugs that address cardiovascular function. Over the next two tutorials, we will focus on how the heart maintains normal rhythm and how drugs can rectify arrhythmia, or an irregularity in the heartbeat, towards normal heart rhythm. Normal cardiac rhythm is primarily maintained by the sinoatrial node, which generates action potentials spontaneously through a chain reaction of ion channels opening and closing at the node. Each channel event triggers the opening of a new channel based on changes of action potential triggered by the previous channel's action. Once the SAN generates coordinated action potentials, it is conducted through the bundle of His and the atrioventricular node and permeates throughout the cardiac monocytes, which are the muscle cells of the heart. Let's first learn about the physiology of heart rhythm, which will assume some knowledge regarding action potentials. So if this topic is unfamiliar to you, please check out my tutorial on neural conduction and action potential from the biopsychology series before continuing here. Counterintuitively, the first phase of SAN action potential generation is known as phase 4. However, since this is a repeating sequence of events, it isn't terribly important where in the cycle one considers the beginning. Before phase 4, the SAN cells are polarized at negative 60 millivolts. This activates voltage-gated sodium channels such that sodium ions enter the SAN cells down their electrochemical gradient. These sodium channels are strangely known as funny channels, also known as hyperpolarization cyclic nucleotide channels, or HCN channels, due to their atypical function of being a positive intracellular influx current that is slow to open. Usually, inward depolarization currents are fast and bring about rapid repolarization, which is critical for normal action potential generation in the nervous system. These HCN channels are primarily expressed on the SAN and are thought to be the main current that dictates normal cardiac rhythmicity. Following HCN activation at negative 60 millivolts and subsequent depolarization to approximately negative 40 millivolts, T-type calcium channels are activated. This is a rapid influx of calcium and rapidly depolarizes the SAN cells, which is known as phase 0 of the SAN action potential. Now at plus 20 millivolts, potassium channels are activated and potassium ions flow down their electrochemical gradient from inside the SAN cell outward to the extracellular space. This loss of positively charged potassium ions from inside the SAN cells causes rapid hyperpolarization, setting up the SAN cell to begin phase 4. We can start to appreciate how this sequence of events generates rhythm, as each channel's activity primes the next channel in a loop that eventually gives rise to automaticity and a physiological heart rate, which is typically 60 to 100 beats per minute. Now we will consider how the electrical activity of the SAN permeates the heart and leads to coordinated cardiac contractility. In a basal state, cardiac myocytes use ATP to exchange sodium and calcium efflux with potassium influx, since the myocytes are losing more positive charge through dual calcium and sodium efflux than is gained from potassium ion influx. The myocyte is hyperpolarized at a baseline of around negative 90 millivolts. However, cardiac myocytes have specialized structures in their cells called gap junctions. These allow ions to move from one myocyte to the next, propagating electrical continuity between the whole heart. This is critical, given that changes in the SAN cell's potential difference influences the membrane potential of neighboring cells through movement of cations from cells in the SAN to nearby myocytes through these gap junctions. Movement of cations through the gap junctions causes a small depolarization of the myocyte from approximately negative 90 millivolts to negative 70 millivolts, which is the threshold to trigger a new ion channel activation cascade similar to the SAN action potential we described. Once the myocytes reach negative 70 millivolts, voltage-gated sodium channels are activated. These are different from the HCN channels and are more typical of voltage-gated sodium channels throughout the nervous system, in that they activate quickly once the potential difference threshold is met and cause a rapid influx of sodium ions. This is also known as phase 0, as with SAN action potential generation. Phase 1 occurs at about 40 millivolts and is marked by the voltage-gated sodium channels inactivating and closing, and voltage-gated potassium channels opening, causing an initial repolarization through potassium ion efflux. On a similar time frame, phase 2 is occurring, which is analogous to phase 1, apart from the important difference that slow to activate calcium channels begin to open, which delays the repolarization caused by potassium efflux. This holds the membrane potential steady at 10 millivolts for a short period of time, approximately 100 milliseconds. Depolarization and calcium influx causes calcium-induced calcium release from the sarcoplasmic reticulum. As we learned from previous tutorials on muscle cell contraction, calcium mediates contraction through troponin and myosin cycling. This intracellular calcium concentration increase in the myocyte induces contraction. Following phase 2 is phase 3, where calcium channels close and potassium efflux is sustained and supported extensively by slow delay rectifier potassium channels, which, as the name suggests, rectifies the depolarization back towards baseline until resting potential is reached, ready for phase 0 to reoccur for the next heartbeat. It's important to note that retroactive contraction of the heart is not possible due to the refractory period caused by phases 0 through 3. This is important because it means that myocytes contract and cause depolarization in neighboring cells in a unilateral directive mechanism, and the electrical activity caused by ion movement can't cause contractions in previously activated myocytes. This leads to a wave of electrical activity that causes cardiac contraction in a progression across the SAN, the bundle of His, and the atrioventricular node, with conserved continuity in one direction, kind of like a crowd doing the wave at a stadium. And with that, we have a basic understanding of the physiology that maintains normal heart rhythm. We are now ready to move forward and examine drugs that address arrhythmias. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.